Uno dei maggiori punti di forza della MMT è il programma di Job Guarantee, un programma le cui radici si ritrovano in Ayman Minsky, ma che è stato auspicato anche da altri personaggi della storia come Martin Luther King, Frederick Lee, docente di microeconomia alla UNKC, pur condividendo totalmente l'analisi tecnica del Job Guarantee, ritiene che la disoccupazione sia intrinseca al modo di produzione capitalistico, punto che sollevò anche Kaleski nel 1943 e che viene ripreso anche oggi da alcuni pensatori marxisti. Lei crede che nel capitalismo, con i suoi rapporti di forza tra classi, sia possibile mantenere un permanente pieno impiego? One of the key strong points of MMT is the Job Guarantee Program. Its roots proceed from Ayman Minsky's work, as well as others in history like Martin Luther King, who aimed to a federal program of public works in 1965-68. Professor Frederick S. Lee, professor of microeconomic analysis at UNKC, totally supports the technical analysis of the job guarantee and at the same time considers unemployment to be intrinsic in the capitalistic way of production. Such analysis was also raised by Kaleski in 1943 and today is shared in several Marxist authors. Do you think that within capitalism and its power relation among classes, a permanent full employment can be achieved?
Yeah. So my professor, Ayman Minsky, used to always say that, you know, there are 51 varieties of capitalism. And so I think that we can come up with a form of capitalism in which we actually do operate with full employment, in the sense that we offer a job to anyone who's ready and willing to work. So that's the idea of the job guarantee or the employer of last resort. I think that it is consistent with a version of capitalism. It's a version that operates at full employment rather than with a reserve army of the unemployed. You have a reserve army of the employed. And so what we've been trying to argue is that a reserve army of the employed actually works better than a reserve army of the unemployed. It keeps your labor in good shape, rather than having your labor unemployed, and especially if it's long-term unemployed, developing bad habits, bad attitudes, losing skills, becoming, from the perspective of employers, becoming unemployable, which is a huge problem in the United States, but also in Europe over the past 20 years or so, that the long-term unemployed become unemployable. The employers will never hire them. So we need something to break that cycle. We need the job guarantee to step in, to give people jobs, to keep them employable, so that when the business sector starts growing, they can hire people out of that pool. So we view this as a buffer stock. And like any buffer stock, what it does is it sets a floor price to wages. It doesn't push up wages. So the fear, and especially in the Kaleski article, the fear was that if you use Keynesian kinds of policies in order to keep the economy operating at a very high level of aggregate demand, in order to keep most people employed, you will start to get inflation. And you will have trouble, from the capital's perspective, disciplining your labor force, because they don't fear they're going to lose their job because it's easy to get jobs. The job guarantee employer of last resort program keeps you at full employment without necessarily keeping aggregate demand high. So that is why it's not going to have the inflationary impacts of a Keynesian sort of approach. And it's not going to have the same disciplining problems, because it is just a buffer stock at, we hope, a living wage. And employers can always recruit out of that pool by paying a slightly higher wage and giving slightly better benefits. So there's always an incentive to try to get out of this pool and into the private sector or the regular government sector jobs that pay a higher wage. So we don't think that it's actually subject to either the inflation threat or the disciplining problems that Kolesky was worrying about.